Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. All praise and glorifications are due to Allah, the Almighty, the Sustainer, the Cherisher. May His peace and blessings be upon Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all His companions and His followers to the Day of Judgment. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, today we are going to be discussing about ashuh, stinginess. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
المال والبنون زينة الحياة الدنيا.
The wealth and the children are the adornment of this worldly life. They decorate life. They make life more interesting on earth and more adorable. But you also need to remember that what Allah says again regarding these two gifts that accompany life. He says,
وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةٌ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ أَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ.
And know that your worldly possessions, wealth, and your children are a test and temptation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah has greater rewards with Him for every one of us, especially those who are going to pass the test. We therefore need to know how to treat each and every one of these gifts. They can be a means of achieving goodness and greatness in the hereafter, or a means of destruction starting on this earth. Many people sometimes are here with us and willing to share everything that they have, starting from their possessions and their moments and time, simply because they don't have much. But the moment they have an extra in the custodianship of what they've been given from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they become unreachable and untouchable in most cases. It starts becoming insufficient for them, to such an extent that they don't even want to spend on their own children, their family members and relatives, even their friends, from that wealth. Why? It is not enough for them. It is not enough for me. They are never satisfied from what they have. It's because they have been overtaken by the disease of the heart, which is stinginess. It is a very contagious heart disease. The only way of treating this toxic disease and purifying oneself from such a disease is to pay zakat and start spending in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A stingy person is very much disliked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He issued a very strong warnings after warnings regarding miserliness. He says,
فَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يَبِخَلْ وَمَنْ يَبِخَلْ فَإِنَّمَا يَبِخَلْ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ.
From amongst them are those people who are stingy, who are miserly, and whosoever is stingy and miserly is miserly and greedy upon himself only.
وَاللَّهُ الْغَنِيُّ وَأَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ.
Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is self-sufficient and all of you are poor without exception. No matter how much you think you have, you are poor in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah does not benefit in any way from what we possess in this world. And do not ever think that, even for a second, that the moment you give anything to anyone, your wealth is lessening. No, that's not it. In fact, the practice of keeping amassing wealth without spending in the path of Allah is not at all good for us. It doesn't benefit us in any way. Rather, it is a source of humiliation and great punishment from Allah. As He says,
وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ بِمَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ هُوَ خَيْرًا بَلْ هُوَ شَرٌّ لَهُمْ سَيُطَوَّقُونَ بِمَا بَخِلُوا بِهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ.
Those who are stingy with what Allah has given them from His bounties should not even think that it is good for them. But in fact, it is very bad for them. It is to their greatest advantage. Why? سَيُطَوَّقُونَ بِمَا بَخِلُوا بِهِ. They are going to be tied on their necks, or on their necks, with what Allah has given them, what they used to be stingy with, on the Day of Judgment, not in honor but in humiliation on the Day of Judgment. For own information, it is said in a hadith that a generous person is close to Allah, close to paradise, close to people, and far from hell. However, a miserly person is far from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, far from paradise, far from people, but very close to hell. And jahilun sakhiyun ahabba ila Allahi min abidin bakhilin. An ignorant person who is generous is more beloved to Allah than a worshipper who is greedy, who is stingy. This alone can explain why most rich people have what's so called the disease of the rich, Why? Most probably many of them have gone far away and far miles away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the reason why they are now depressed with so-called disease of the rich. In another hadith, the rich will not move a single inch, even a single step on the day of judgment until they are asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about their wealth, how they got it, how they spent it, and from where they got it. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you think that we are going to give you restless times? In fact, it is a sign of becoming stingy as well if you start concealing Allah's favors and bounties upon you. They should manifest in you. Don't hide it. It just happens naturally. Don't try to conceal it. Do you think that we are going to give you restless times, begging you, knocking on your door on a daily basis to beg from you? No! It is a sign of shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in you showing the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ وَيَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبُخْلِ وَيَكْتُمُونَ مَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ وَأَعْتَدْنَا لِلْكَافِرِينَ عَذَابًا مُهِينًا.
Those who are greedy, miserly, and they encourage others to be greedy and miserly as well, and stingy, and they hide what Allah has given them from His bounties. Indeed, Allah has prepared for them, for the disbelievers, a very humiliating punishment. Why are they being called disbelievers? They are not appreciating the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's it. With these few words, my dear brothers and sisters, till we meet again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.